stop me if you think that you heard this one before. Stop me.
Hey, what's up? My name is Mark Ronson. We're here at Metropolis Studios. Just putting the finishing touches on my album version. It's kind of amazing because you like start these little songs, you make them in your room or in your home studio. They start in an MPC and then they end up in a giant room like this with like 18 people on like violins, violas and stuff. And it's really like kind of like, it's the most gratifying part of the recording thing because it's like, it's the only thing you can't do in your room. You know, we live in an age where you can do a lot of stuff with computers, Pro Tools, but like when it comes to things like horns and strings and things that I love, like, because they're all on my favorite record. It's like the extra icing on the cake to do like strings. It's like having it, because you know, I come from like a hip hop school of producing where it's like you do a beat and then like that's kind of like to have this and have these, the band that played on this that sound like an old sort of 60s record I was sampled and then have the strings on top of it. It's kind of amazing. I go to Chris's house, we do the string arrangements together and he plays like the fake string sounds on his keyboards and we get thing that we like and like, oh, this should be bells, no, let's change this line. He charts it out on the thing and then we bring it in here and he sits in front of the orchestra and does that and uses words that I have no idea what he's saying.
I love it. Do you know what the one thing that, you know that Mysterioso section? Did you make that word up or not?
That was the thing on like Amy's record. She was like, no strings the whole time. And I remember the first time we did the strings and I was like cringing while she was listening to it, just thinking she's gonna hate it. She just looked up with this like big smile. It's like, I wouldn't want to put strings on everything or horns on everything either. It's just a matter of what the song calls for, but it's more about not being afraid to go really grand when you feel that it can go.
I get so excited that last, I guess it's the last eight bars of the outro when the high strings do that. It's almost like if it goes. If that, almost that line could be repeated while the other line's going down, is it?